right, thank you so much for tuning back in to another reaction video. My name is Chris.
My name is Sam.
And we are Offset.
Era.
All right, and as you bring, as we see in the title, we're bringing back
NEKI.
We decided after checking out the last one, it was just amazing. It was super fast as soon as you hit play. It was so good. We loved them so much. I had such a great time watching it. So you guys suggested their other new video that just came out 2 weeks ago. It's called Maze. It's another music video.
I like how it says in the description, "Welcome to Hell" with a little heart next to it.
Yes.
I work retail 40 hours a week. I know what you're talking about.
Exactly.
I'm already in hell.
So a couple of things we gleaned from the last one. One of the big things is the bass player.
You can edit that out.
The bass player was actually a finalist when Love Bites was looking for a replacement bass player.
Wow.
She was one of the finalists. I think the only reason they didn't choose her is because of her age.
I think the comments said she was like 15.
Yeah.
Wow.
So, but yeah, it makes a lot of sense because she's phenomenal. And I think honestly, she's getting a lot to shine here.
Absolutely.
Versus what Love Bites. Love Bites is not a bass driven band, really. It's more guitar.
Yeah, very guitar oriented. So, very like soaring vocals, the driving, dueling guitars,
And
there's,
all the drumming and stuff.
Oh yes, the monster drumming. Whereas the bass kind of like the obviously the bass is like the music video that we reacted to from Love Bites. The bass is obviously present in the mix.
Right.
Otherwise, it'd be lacking.
Right.
But
it's not the
focal point. But if we want to hear the bass really take the time to shine, that's more Bandmaid's alley or NEKI.
Yeah. All right, let's look at some of these comments and
jump in. As a bass guitarist, I appreciate that.
Right. This one says, they seriously need to add a love it button. Times like this,
Remember the rating system YouTube used to have?
Yep.
Used to rate five, like 1 to 5 stars. I commented on one, like, really, like, lo-fi quality Celtic Frost video from when they were playing in Texas or something, and I was like, oh hell yeah, I was like, hell yeah, double 5 stars. Uh-huh.
You can always count on Kanade, I think is how you say her name, to play
some killer bass lines.
Yeah.
All right, so I know I'm gonna be really digging this one too.
Huh.
This is the best of the songs they've released so far. The drums and bass have been strong in all their songs, but in the prior songs, either the guitarist or singer or both were lacking in comparison. This is not me saying that. This is the comment.
Yep.
This is the first song where, to me, it felt like each individual was performing at a similar high level.
Okay. Sometimes songs are not all about who performs at an equal level. It's just about serving the song.
Exactly.
I get what you're saying, and hopefully we'll see that in this video.
Oh, so glad Bandmade finally got a sister. That's great.
Yes.
I love that.
We love Bandmade too.
Yes, we love Bandmade.
All right. Well, we're at that time. Let's go and jump into
this one. Yes, let's get jumping. And for anyone out there jumping in with us for the very first time, welcome to the channel.
Welcome indeed. That'll be our second time checking out NEKI. So yep. If you guys want to see more, I know there's a couple other in the suggestions that we're seeing. There's one called Regan Girl. We can also check out that one. So let us know.
There's another one, right? Oh wait, that's a different project.
There's a couple other similar acts also popping up. So with our other stuff, we need to be checking out similar acts, similar bands, or
Live performances, or
we're here for it.
Yes.
Put it in the comments. Put it in our community tab under the latest suggestion thread. But if you're not new,
you know what time it is. It's time for
the glorious,
the epic transition.
All right, here we go. NEKI. Don't know what to expect from this one. The other one was blazing. Let's see what we got. We'll see.
It's called Maze.
Yep, Maze official video. Here we go. What the crap? What the crap? The drums sound good. Oh, that stuck!
Oh, that was so tight.
What? So it looks like she did a snare and then like a thing on the feet.
Yeah.
I really like her voice too. There's a lot of like play with her voice, a lot of kind of like a cry kind of a sensation where she's flipping her voice almost like a, like some, not like a cracking, but you can make your song, your voice kind of crack, but in key kind of what's happening. So she's bending her voice, doing that and like pushing it out and then bending it. And it's just really cool. The bass is driving the song for the most part, but there's the drumming and the guitar playing is really ample to the rest of the composition.
Yeah.
And then when it comes in, it's like got like this like a, almost like a disco kind of a which makes the song drive and dance, but they're driving it with hard heavy guitar, which
and
the, is
and
really
their
guitars cool.
Sound so powerful,
so crunchy.
great tone.
I love it.
And that bass is unstoppable.
Oh, she's so good. Yeah, I whether, love how you know, it drives the whole
yeah
thing.
Whether you know whether it's you know slapping and you know it, you know, it's staying up with the drums and mm-hmm. or when you know she's you know when she's doing fingerstyle and doing all those cool you know those cool walking fills like that.
Oh yeah, it's so good. Nice.
One thing I'm noticing in this given in this particular part of the song, her bass like slapping or I don't know, I can't see if she's slapping in that section.
Mm.
It's very rhythmic.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Very
very
good.
Very rhythmic. Very much locking in with the drums, like being like letting it it enables the bass to shine. But in a different way.
Yeah.
You know, instead of going all the way, like going like up and down the neck and doing like flares like that,
mm-hmm.
it's rhythmic, but it, you know, combine that with, you know, with the very, how prevalent it is in the mix,
mm-hmm.
it adds an extra layer to the rhythm.
Yeah. She's going bam 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 bam, like the way she's percussioning and then opening the hi-hat, bam bam bam, snare bam 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 bam. I love how they're doing there. Whole band is going along with it. So I don't know who wrote that part. I don't know if the drummer was like, hey, what are we about? I'm always curious, like, who came up with that? Was the guitarist like doing something and that she just decided to do that, or was she like, we need like a shift up, maybe if I go bam 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 and you guys do that with me? It's always interesting to see how the story kind of unfolds on how things are, because for me that's interesting. We're a band, so there's always like something kind of interesting to talk about, you know, like how the song came about, what they did, who came up with what part. But I always love that kind of stuff about it. But this is just a crazy creative way of doing something different in the middle of a song. Oh, what a stop! Nice. I love how they left the finger style, like the finger noise of the guitar.
Yeah, that scrape.
Yeah. So, they're steadily becoming some of my favorites.
Yes.
I really, really, really like this. It's just really up my alley. I mean, it's what we attracted to us to Bandmate originally, I think, yeah. Too. Not to say that they're going to replace them in any way. It's just nice to see that there's other groups coming up in the same kind of vein, but also making it their own. This is way... I would say more accessible in a lot of ways to Bandmate because the vocal for me is a little stronger in my opinion. I mean, don't come off me for that, but I have my rights to my opinions. I like her style a little bit better than some of the other stuff in Bandmate. I love Bandmate. Don't get me wrong. I love Bandmate so much, but I really, really like this. I really hope that they can.
It's got a little bit of like a pop punk kind of vibe.
Yeah, so that's kind of why I think I like it too.
Pop. It's more up your alley.
It's more consistent. But I don't know. There's so much to it. There's technicality in the drums. There's composition, smart composition things where the bass is going, where the drums are just playing. Lots of drops out of the bass, guitar,
and really, really tight stops. After they're like "Welcome to Hell," you know, like you would think that's where the song's gonna end.
Yeah.
But then, you know, like, you feel the pin drop, and then boom, it goes right back into it.
God, and the vocals, I like this band a lot. I hope they catch on. I want to listen to more of their stuff. So, yeah, you guys help us steer our direction of which one we're going to check out next. I know there's a limited amount because they are new, but we will continue on this journey as long as you guys are here for it. So let us know in the comments which song we should check out next.
And we will do that.
Absolutely. If they have anything out live that's worth checking out, let us know that as well. We're absolutely happy to look at all those. But in the meantime, we are Offset Era.
Two-thirds of Offset Era, Southwest Florida's premier three-piece punkcore act. We have an extensive playlist of all of our original music if you're interested as to what punkcore entails.
Yep.
And a fun, fresh, and powerful 6-track EP called Top Shelf Villain. It's been out now for going on 6 months in September.
Yep.
And a really cool music video to check out for that title track to Top Shelf Villain, well, called Top Shelf Villain.
Oh, yes. We were going to do more videos, but now we're recording more music. So, I don't know.
Yep. We're really having a cool time jamming on your music. We even got one of our new songs down to where we can add it to the set list.
Yep. So we're playing a brand new song at shows now. It's called Anthem of Broken Dreams. Anthem of Shattered Dreams. We may or may not put that out as a single before the album drops. So we'll keep an eye out for that. It's a cool song. Hopefully you guys will check it out.
It's really fun to play.
We're very happy to see that topic on our channel, the Offset Era topic, has been gaining like subscribers. Which,
yeah.
You know, I'd never really talk about that as much. That channel is created by our digital distributor, which is DistroKid.
Yeah.
So it's not really our channel, but we link it. But I've seen that.
It's got our name on it.
Yeah, so
it's our music.
It is our music. So I do see the subscriber count going up, and it's nearly at 100. So that's really cool for just something that we don't even talk about. You guys are finding the music and enjoying it. So thank you.
Thank you.
We're playing a lot of shows in different places. So we just got done playing a show last night in Arcadia. And we just got before the week before we were down in Bonita, which is here in Florida. So yep. We're kind of hitting some new spots and getting some good feedback. So thank you guys for being here. Speaking of shows, we got one coming up.
Saturday, August 17th, we're going to be at Rackham Spirits and Times in Cape Coral with Nine Soft and Cruel Curses.
Yeah, it's going to be a great show. We love Rackham's. It's been a while since we played there. If you guys are in the area, please come out. It's a great sound system. There's pools, full bar.
We're going to be toasting 10 years.
10 freaking years of doing this. Me and Vince have been at it for a while. He came in not too long ago, but long ago.
Going on 4 years
for me. 4 years flying by, man.
I know.
Seems like
I think I have the longest tenure of any bass player.
You do. And you'll stick with us because we're keeping him.
If you want me, you got to fight for me.
Exactly. But if you are interested in following the band, we do have a Facebook. We have Instagram. Of course, you can follow us here on YouTube as well.
And we also have a Patreon.
Yeah, check our Patreon out. It's a good way just to support us. You want to directly give funds directly to us and not worry about our playlists and all that stuff. It helps us out.
You're not under any obligation to do so, but we greatly appreciate it. Yeah. We understand, you know, given the, you know, state of, you know, the state that we live in,
right?
State of the world that we live in, you know, cost of living is outrageous. So,
right.
In any case, we greatly appreciate it.
One benefit we do offer on the Patreon is anything that gets blocked, we usually put it on that channel so you can see it in all of its glory without any editing. So,
make sure uncensored.
Yep. But yeah, that's it. Thank you again for liking, commenting, and subscribing. Let us know what you want to see in the next one.
And we'll see you then.
We'll see you there. Peace out.